what you heard is true, but I can't stop thinking about you and I. Said I've been there too a few times. 'Cause you got that dreams, to perform for this room of incredible, very influential human beings. Thank you so much for wanting to like be there while I'm here doing this. Appreciate it. And thank you to Time Magazine for putting on this event. It's really wonderful. Like every time this magazine issue comes out every year, I read it cover to cover. And just having read the stories of the people who are here tonight, I'm just so honored and happy and in awe of everything you're doing in all these different facets, all these different ways that you're influencing the world. You're actually, just by definition of the whole thing, changing the world in so many different ways. And all the different reasons that you're in the magazine and in the room tonight, you've been working at those things for your whole lives, probably. And it's just really cool to get to be in the room when you're honored. I'm honored to be with you while you're honored. It's just a whole honor. Thanks, guys. Thank you. I think the reason why I would be on the list is because of the things I write, predominantly songs, occasionally open letters, the odd op-ed, lengthy Instagram caption or something. But mostly it's songs. And for me, writing, I've always known that it was the main pillar holding up my career. I've always known it was the main pillar of kind of my sanity as well. Like, I've always looked at writing as sort of a protective armor, which is weird because you'd think that writing about your life, that's usually likened to vulnerability. But I think that when you write about your life, it gives you the ability to process your life and to kind of, I use it as a way of justifying things that happened to me, whether they're good or bad. You know, I like to honor the good times and really process the bad times when I write. Like when I first started writing when I was 12. And when I'd be at school and I'd have a really bad day and like nobody would want to talk to me or something, I'd just sit there and go like, no, it's okay, I'm gonna write a song about this when I get home. And then when I write that song, maybe I'll feel like this day was worth it. Like it sucked, but it was maybe worth it if I write something about this feeling that I'm proud of. And I love my job. I love that I get to write. I love that so many women came before me and opened the door that I now get to walk through who were writing about their lives, and I'm so grateful for that opportunity. One of my favorite quotes is how Nora Ephron used to say, everything is copy. Mm-hmm. Everything that happened to her, she used as inspiration. And I think that one of my favorite things about female writers, about writers in general, about people who take what happens to them and they process it and they put it out into the world, is if you write, you can turn your lessons into your legacy. And so I'm just really happy to get to do this.
Dreaming of me.
gonna do a quick move over there. I'll be right there. So the first time I was ever on this magnificent list was when I was. One second, just gonna take this off. Nobody look. It's very unladylike. So basically, first time I was on the time list, it was almost 10 years ago, actually. So I was, I performed in Khalid's spot, and I'm a huge, huge Khalid fan. So if, yeah. If you haven't listened to his new album, Free Spirit, then that's a real, like, loss. It's a real wasted opportunity. It's a perfect album. You're welcome. Thank you. But the first time I was here, I'm pretty sure it was mostly based on this one song that I wrote when I was 17. And when I was 17, my whole life was like playing shows in clubs and bars. My mom had to come because I was not like, I couldn't legally get into them to play in them. And when I get home, I'd hang out with my best friend Abigail, who's sitting right there. Hey. And then I would just like watch endless hours of Grey's Anatomy. And I know that Sandra Oh is in the room, which shakes me to my very core. It's my whole life there. And I just, you know, would think about what, you know, what love would be like, and obviously over-dramatize and romanticize it when I would write songs about it. And so there was a song that I wrote alone in my bedroom called Love Story.
Be the princess, it's a love story, baby, just say.
The idea of all of us being here tonight, which is so amazing. But I also think about, like, when I see all of you, I just think about all the time you put into what you do, all the dedication that you've had to have. Like, when you first got the idea, hey, this is what I want to do, this is the path I want to follow, like, that is what's interesting to me. And then also what's interesting to me is the people around you that said, oh yeah, you really should do that. You're great at that. And the people who, when you did gain influence, were real enough with you to be very honest with you about how you should use that influence. Because I think that's another interesting thing about this whole thing, where you're doing what you love, you're doing what you're passionate about, you're standing up for what you want to stand up for. But at that point, we're all still learning. And we need people around us to be honest with us, to be still compassionate and empathetic with us, to be patient with us. Everybody needs that. And sometimes I always think about things in metaphor. I never don't do that. My brain is like, oh, I have a metaphor. So sometimes I think about, life and these wonderful moments of celebration, like New Year's Eve, and it's like the countdown and the champagne and everything's glitter. There's so much glitter. It's amazing. And then I think about who's actually there with you the next day to clean up the house. and I think that's the important thing. There's this quest where we're trying to follow our dreams and be who we want to be and be remembered and all that, but then, you know, we're not always gonna, like, people aren't always gonna like us, we're not always gonna be on really great lists like this, but if you can find the people around you who, metaphorically speaking, would clean up the house with you the next day after the party, that's kind of what I wrote this song about. It's called New Year's Day. Midnight.
recognize anywhere. Please don't ever become a stranger whose laugh I can recognize anywhere. There's glitter on the floor after the party.
You know when you don't like think a plan through, and you just you're like, I have to stand back up and play my guitar again, so I'm just gonna put this on. It's fine. It's Velcro. I'm 5 years old. I'm gonna get back up and sing one more song.
Yeah. Woo!
You guys have the best night ever, and just keep doing what you're doing, even if it doesn't get you on a list, even if people aren't clapping, even if it feels like you're flying into the wind. Just keep doing what you're doing, because I appreciate you so much, and I'm so happy to be in this room with you. And I don't know, like, what can we say about how the journey is gonna be? I just feel like, you know, just keep doing what you're doing, even though the haters are gonna hate, you know? I see you're too late.
Bye.
this new girlfriend. She's like, oh